Many of you have requested a color grading tutorial specifically for the Sony a7 III. So today I will show you my workflow to color grade footage shot on this camera. Let's dive in. The first thing we need to do is change the color space and gamma to Davinci Wide Gamut Intermediate and Rec. 709A. While the regular Rec. 709 can be used, I found that Rec. 709A provides cleaner results when exporting to QuickTime, so that's why I'll be using it. Now let's import a random clip that I shot in Croatia a while ago. This clip was shot in the HLG2 8-bit 422, so nothing too special. I'll be using this clip for demonstration and I haven't graded it before. To start, I'll add two color space transforms. In the first CST, I will convert the clip from HOG Gamma and Rec. 709 color space to Davinci Wide Gamut and Davinci Intermediate. In the second CST, I'll transform it from Davinci Wide Gamut and Davinci Intermediate back to Rec. 709 and Rec. 709A. Everything we grade between these nodes will be graded in the Davinci Wide Gamut Intermediate color space. This gives us much more space to work with. I also add another CST and convert it from Rec. 709 and Rec. 709A to Rec. 709 and Cineon Film Lock, so that I can add a built-in film print LUT. Using an extra CST allows me to compound the nodes and change the key output without changing any of the transformation, adjusting only the film print intensity. So now I'll just do some basic corrections with the primaries. I turn down the lift a bit and pull up the gain to create a natural contrast. As you can see in the scopes, the highlights aren't clipping and the shadows aren't as well. It's recommended to keep them above the zero level because otherwise you're losing details in your shadows. I'll add another node for the saturation and I'll begin to correct the saturation on this node. By changing the color space of the node to HSV and disabling the first and third channels, I will disable the hue and value, so it only affects the saturation. Then I'll increase the gain to add saturation and keep the image looking natural. I found that this way of adding saturation gives a much cleaner result. After I've corrected the saturation, I'll correct the contrast a little bit more. I'll fine-tune it with the contrast slider and change the pivot a bit. After that, I'll just correct the white balance. For the white balance, I use the chromatic adaptation effect. By changing the method to Bradford and the illuminant type to color temperature, I can adjust the white balance by its Kelvin. I really like this way of correcting the white balance. With using the temperature slider, you're just pushing yellow or blue into the image. By using the chromatic adaptation, you're actually changing the temperature in Kelvins. As you can see, there's a lot of blue in the highlights, but that's because I haven't enabled the film print LUT. As you can see now, everything is quite balanced and it's looking good. I'll move the nodes and create another node. On this node, I will create a power window. I'll create a circle around the object, and that's the house in this case. I'll increase the softness a bit, and you can do that by going to the softness slider or just clicking and dragging on one of the red dots. I'll pull up the gamma and the gain. Then I will press Option O on my keyboard to create the outside of the power window. This inverts the mask to a new node. this note, I'll decrease the lift, decrease the gamma, and check the results. As you can see, now I've created a natural vignette. On the next note, I'm gonna apply the glow effect. I'm going to switch the composite type to soft light and decrease the shine threshold all the way down. Next, I will slowly increase the shine threshold and play with the opacity and spread. I'll turn down the opacity and label the note. Then I will add another glow effect. On this effect, I will change the composite type to screen. I will do this to soften the highlights a bit. I will increase the spread, turn down the shine threshold, and turn down the opacity. Now I notice the sky is white. I don't really like it, so I'll increase the blues a bit. As you can see, this looks much better. I label the note as look. Now I'll add some sharpness. Make sure not to overdo this because I don't want the footage to look digital. Then I'll add some grain to get rid of any bending or artifacts. Usually I just leave the film grain on its current preset. I think it looks okay, but you can choose another one if you want. I'll adjust the white balance a bit to ensure the white balance still looks good. Then I'll add my own LUT. This LUT adds a little bit of contrast and ensure all my shots look the same. I want a consistent grade, so that's why I always use a LUT for extra safety. I think it's too intense right now, so I turn down the key output. As we were correcting this image, quite some noise came into the image. That's why I apply a temporal noise reduction. Lastly, I will add one more power window to ensure that the wall doesn't distract. I'll decrease the shadows and midtones a bit using the curve tool. And that's it. For a more detailed guide to color correction, make sure to download my ebook. First 50 people will get a 40% discount, so be sure to check it out.